I'm a scientist because I care very much about the details of things. I don't just like to know what is happening, but why and how. I'm an engineer because I like to use the why and the how to identify solutions to problems. My name is Laura Bowling. I'm an associate professor in the agronomy department. I'm a hydrologist here at Purdue, and for me that means that I study the distribution of water in the Earth's system and what controls how much water goes where. My home in the College of Agriculture means that I'm particularly interested in the interaction of water and agriculture. A lot of my research focuses on drainage water management. Drainage is very important to agricultural production here in the Midwest, but it represents a huge disruption of the water cycle, and it's not always needed. So a lot of my research focuses on how could we store more water in the landscape when we don't need drainage for crop production, and the impacts of that on things like flood frequency and the downstream transport of nutrient loads. I also research how the changing demand for water for irrigation impacts future water supplies and hydrologic response. Research on agricultural drainage and irrigation matters because although we continue to have abundant water supply here in Indiana, demand for water continues to increase. At the same time, increased variability in precipitation makes irrigation from either stored water or groundwater more and more desirable as a method for farmers to manage risk. Any change in upstream water use has the potential to have cascading effects downstream in the form of changing water supply to ecosystems, increased flood frequency, or increased transport of nutrients to the Gulf of Mexico. By evaluating the entire water cycle simultaneously, we can better anticipate the unintended consequences of water use decisions. I think everyone should realize that climate change means so much more than a simple increase in global mean temperature. In particular, the ability of different land use types to store water, whether as soil moisture, snow, or in lakes and wetlands, and the huge amount of energy involved in melting or evaporating that water, can result in changes that are completely unintuitive, such as an increase in soil frost in a warmer climate, or an increase in the volume of Western Himalayan glaciers.